welcome. Update on this little engine, whose only real problem was dead space in the cold piston. I've fixed that. I think it's running now pretty well as it ever will. I have a little bit of steel wool in the displacer there. I don't think it's doing anything. And this design, at least this particular engine design, has a functional flywheel. This other engine I'm working on, the flywheel is only so functional. What's generally still missing from these things is a way to take power off correctly. Power should be taken off with reduction at the crankshaft. Even to drive a tiny little load like what these things have on them, a little DC permanent magnet motor, these things need a little bitty pulley or gear that will allow something like 6 or 8 to 1 reduction at the load. The goal is, superficially, the goal is to not is to have the engine not slow down very much, because it's low torque, so you don't want to be forced to slow down by the load. So mechanical advantage is the way these things are correctly loaded. Most prime movers are loaded with reduction. Look at the way a compressor is run, or machinery, the motor, the power source, the prime mover, almost always is configured with mechanical advantage over the load. So you can see that I've taped this down, and that's helping matters. These little base plates, only partially damp the unavoidable vibration that's there. I think taping is a good compromise, in lieu of having it anchored to something different, something more stable, more solid. So yay for my team. These, one of the advantages of this type, this iteration of lathe, is the way the duct is configured so that there's more or less actual physical separation between the hot and cold sides. That needs to be there in some of these older designs, where the hot and cold side are right next to each other. Bad. In the long run, bad. This is a simple way to fix that. Some of these others use a piece of rubber tubing to make the duct, but it's still, there's still this physical separation. That's a really good thing. So this flywheel gives a really good runout on this engine after the flame is extinguished. So, almost. I did discover that olive oil works on squeaky spots. I was going to try the some Teflon tape, which probably would have worked, but so did the oil. Thanks.